Have you ever had an amazing idea, but you know if you didn't capture it quickly, it would just poof, be gone and forgotten about forever? But you're nowhere near a pad of paper and a pen, and there's no easy, convenient way for you to just jot it down? So what are you gonna do? My name's Dylan Stewart. They call me the Mac Whisperer. And in this video today, I'm gonna teach you exactly how to solve that problem. One of the most underutilized and underrated apps on the iPhone is called Voice Memo. It's been around for a long time and it's a really simple app that can allow you to capture audio from all sorts of different circumstances, like that great idea that you've got or that lecture that you're sitting in that you want to listen back to at your own convenience. It's a really simple app, but it's got some advanced features that you might not stumble across on your own. So in today's video, I'm going to teach you how to easily record a voice memo, how to edit it, how to share it, how to save it, and how to sort and organize your voice memos so you can find the one you're looking for quickly and easily. If you stick around to the end, I'm going to talk about the iPhone 15's new action button and how it can work perfectly with the voice memo app. So let's hop over to the iPhone and get started. First thing we need to do is find the Voice Memo app. Here's what it looks like right down here. Fun fact, the icon for the Voice Memo app is actually the word Apple in a waveform. I'm gonna go ahead and press on this Apple and get us started. When you first click on the Voice Memo app, you're gonna find yourself in the All Recordings section. This is where all the voice memos you've ever recorded on this phone or synced with this phone live. The first thing we need to do is click this friendly red button at the bottom of the screen. It's easy enough to do. When you press the red button, it starts recording. And then if you press the square at the bottom, it will stop recording and immediately save it. And just like that, you've created a voice memo. My work here is done. No, it's actually not done. There's actually a lot more we need to talk about in this lesson. In addition to being able to just press the record button, there's an advanced record screen. And the way you get into that is by pressing the record button and swiping up on this panel so that you get it into full screen mode. In full screen mode, you'll notice that the stop button at the bottom has been replaced with a pause button. This means that at any point in your voice memo, you can stop it, so it stops recording. And then when you're ready to continue, just resume from where you left off. And you can do this at any time, even months and months after you've recorded a voice memo. In addition to that, you can replace audio in the voice memo. So let's say you made a mistake or you flubbed your line or you said something you didn't mean to say or you got distracted. You can just move the playhead, which is what they call that blue line, to the position where you made the mistake, and then press the replace button at the bottom and it will begin recording from where you placed the playhead, recording over whatever mistake you made or whatever you wanted to change. When you're done, press the pause button again, and then you can go ahead and click the done button, or you can go to the beginning of the recording and press the play button to hear it back. Let's click the done button here. When you do that, it automatically saves the recording and it titles it. You can always change the name of any recording just by tapping right on it, selecting it, and typing right over it. Now, once you've recorded one, the next thing we want to talk about is playback. You see, when you click on any one of these voice recordings, you get the little play button right in the middle, and you can press that, and it can play through the entire voice recording. You've also got the rewind and fast forward buttons to jump 15 seconds back or 15 seconds forward in case it's a long voice memo. You can also delete it right from here, or you can click the settings button in the lower left-hand corner. The settings button gives you options to change the playback speed to make it slower or faster. In addition, you can click the skip silence button, which will mean if there's a pause in the recording, it'll jump right over that so you don't need to listen to that dead space. And then down at the bottom is the option to enhance the recording, which puts a filter on the audio that cleans it up and makes it just sound so much better. sometimes you may need to edit or trim things, clean it up a little bit. To do that, all you have to do is click on the voice memo and click on the three dots in the upper right-hand corner and choose edit recording, which brings us back into this recording screen, but it also gives us the settings option in the upper left-hand corner, which we looked at a moment ago, and the trim button in the upper right-hand corner. By clicking the trim button here, it will highlight the entire voice memo in yellow. Now, what you can do here is you can pinch or spread to make it smaller or bigger and a little easier to access. When you're here, if you want to trim out a part of the recording, just move the yellow line on the other side of what you want to trim out and press the trim button at the bottom. That will eliminate that section. But one of the other fun things that you can do here is you can actually delete a section. So if you move the yellow pieces into the middle, like where we've got that dead space here, and press delete, it will remove the middle part right out of there, leaving only the other sides of it. By doing this, you can easily come in and clean up and edit and even add to or change the recording that you've made. At any point, just press the resume button and pick up from where you left off, and you can continue with that great idea or whatever other recordings you need to add on here. Let's go ahead and click the done button here. Now, once we've recorded it and we've edited it, now what are we going to do with it? Well, there's two things that most people do with their voice memos. The first one is you might want to send it to someone. It's easy to do by pressing those three buttons again and clicking on the share icon, which brings up our share sheet, which can allow us to text it, airdrop it, send it to an email, drop it in our notes, or put it in reminders or anything we want to do with it. Another thing that people like to do with voice memos is they like to save them and put them on their computer or put them in their files. It's very easy to do that right from the same share screen by just coming to where it says Save to Files, which will save it into iCloud, or you can also save it into Dropbox or Google Drive or other things like that. Now, some people may want to do that to save them and sort them and put them in their filing system, but I'm going to suggest that maybe that's not the easiest way to do that. And the reason is because Voice Memo syncs with iCloud. So you don't really need to save them into your filing system. You can leave them here and synchronize and sort them here. And the last thing I want to talk about is how to properly sort and organize your voice memos. And there's a couple of easy ways to do that. The first one is by using favoriting. By clicking on those three dots again, you'll see one of the options is to favorite this memo. When you favorite a voice memo, it makes it easier for you to find it in the filing section. Where's the filing section, you say? Well, if you press on that arrow in the upper left-hand corner here, you're going to enter a new screen where you have files. And from this screen, you'll see your favorites easily placed, any voice memos you've recently deleted, and any folders. It's easy to create a new folder by clicking on the folder button in the lower right-hand corner here and just giving it a quick name and clicking save. Now you've got a place to put those voice memos so they aren't just all in one place and disorganized. Come into your All Recordings section, and from here you can press the Edit button in the upper right corner, select any of them that you want, click the Share button, and move them to whichever folder makes the most sense. They'll still be in the All Recordings section, but they'll also be organized separately inside of that folder. While you're in the All Recordings screen, if you swipe from the right side to the left, you will get these options that can allow you to quickly delete, file, or press the three dots so that you can share or save or export out that voice memo. And the last thing I want to talk about is the iPhone 15 Pro. You see, the iPhone 15 Pro has that action button on the side. And that action button is super valuable because you can program it to have different actions. And one of the actions is voice memos. So here's how you do that. Swipe up, come into settings, come down until you see the action button section. And from this setting, you can swipe through the different choices to pick voice memos. Which means that just by pressing the side button on your phone, you can immediately capture that idea without even having to unlock your phone. How's that for simple and convenient? So that's what I've got on the Voice Memos app. Take a moment, hit that thumbs up button if you got good value out of this video. And if you've got some great ideas about how you might use voice memos that I didn't mention or didn't think of, drop them down below. I'd love to hear from each of you. My name's Dylan Stewart. They call me the Mac Whisperer, and it's my passion and profession to help you get more done with your Apple products than you ever thought possible. And I will see you at the next video.